Did we not do that because it was the first time, at least ever since I've been on the commission, that we were trying to put our eye on taking care of this year, but also looking out for 2022? Am I getting that correct?
That's correct, which is the budget we're going to be
preparing for. Which is the budget we're currently working on now.
Which is, to the commissioner's point, you know,
yes.
We're going to be looking at reserves. We're going to be looking at the level of needs. And so for instance, okay, you take the $33 million that she's referring to, and I don't know if that's the correct number, but I'm assuming it is. So you take the $33 million, now you have to put in the sheriff did increase expenses. So we need to look at that, right? Now, then we added body cameras. That had a $4 million impact in a one-time cost, but then a $4 million ongoing. So we can add those up, though. We can have a crosswalk to show you where we're at. We're going to be looking at mental health services. But that's my intent for this year's budget, is to show you where you're at. Here's the money that we collected, and here's the changes since then, to where then we can have a discussion about level of service and what we want to provide in the final budget, and whether or not that impacts what that rate should be. That's my intent. And what we're also going to show you, thanks to, is Jim still here? He's still here. I show you a multi-year look at the budget, to where you can see the ongoing operating cost of all the decisions that you make and the impact that it has on our long-term number, to Commissioner Sealpoint, to make sure it's sustainable over time. He created a neat tool that I think will be very helpful for you to be able to visualize kind of where we're at.
So I appreciate your being more clear on that subject matter, Commissioner Peters, because as a final example, I heard you mention the word rollback rate. And as an example of why I have never thought that is really good public policy is because that's exactly what happened at Forward Pinellas a year ago, Commissioner Eggers, or was it 2 years ago?
No, it was probably 5 or 6 years ago when we lowered the millage rate.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, but now we're in a position where that's problematic because we haven't kept up and we have to do something to fill that gap. So that's something to keep in mind as well when you do that. I'm not saying we won't, but I'm just saying it's something to keep in mind. Okay, I'm done. Thank you.
Yeah, and I think that's coming. We're going to have that further conversations in June, and then the actual budget that you're recommending will come to us in July. And I would say that, you know, incremental creep of budgets is kind of natural. It happens. But when we have an opportunity on an incremental reduction, I mean, I don't know what it's going to be. I don't know what that amount's going to end up being.
I understand.
It is important. Mm-hmm. And sometimes it's substantive, and sometimes it's symbolism. I just think we have to, we're all kind of going to be going through that kind of thought process in the next couple of months. We don't want to put ourselves at risk going forward, but we do have some issues at hand. And I think Commissioner Peter spoke to that, what our businesses and residents have gone through, and just kind of a supportive hand or supportive, empathetic messaging is sometimes as important as the amount of dollars that you can actually give back. Because it never amounts, everybody says, well, it's not that much that you're adding on. Well, it's not that much that you're cutting sometimes, but it does send signals. And I think we have to be sensitive and aware of that this year. So, yeah, Commissioner Justice.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. If we're going to have that conversation, I think we should have the full conversation as we're talking about that and what that means. As far as, you know, if there is a reduction or if we stay pat or if we have an increase, all across the spectrum of what that is, total dollars for our budget, but also what it is for each individual property type, you know.
Yep.
You know, and that's a decision. It'll be a policy decision we can make. Is it worth cutting X million from the, you know, we're not cutting, but not being able to meet the sheriff's request or not being able to meet the expanded mental health services that we want to do, or not in order to give, you know, a $2.38. So how much, that needs to be part of that discussion as well.
Yep, absolutely.
Mr. Chair.
Yes,
actually, and we get to that point in the conversation, which we're not there yet. Could we take a look at if budgets are increasing, which parts of our budget are increasing? Is it BCC departments? Is it the sheriff? Is it, you know, where is that coming from? Because
sure, we can have
some of that we have no control over.
I could tell you that right now, but I will have that ready for that discussion.
I can tell you that pretty much.
We will do that. And, you know, I am very, very sensitive to our tax rate, okay, and what we're asking out of our taxpayers. You know, my goal for the BCC departments is for them to be able to, on a continuous basis, find efficiencies to even increase or to absorb the cost of labor, you know, find efficiencies every year. The format that we set up today, or the last 3 days, first, thank you for giving us the time to kind of go through this. We're only halfway there. That's what we've been doing since January, if there's any question. But you can see that you've got the analysts, and some of them, it's the first time ever presenting to a board like this. So, you know, kudos to them for doing a really, really, really good job. You know, this is a learning experience. That's how we grow talent. But it's also how they get ownership of having a fresh set of eyes on the way the department does something. So they can partner with them. They can challenge the status quo. Maybe they have a new idea. Maybe it doesn't work, but maybe it triggers the department to think about something a little bit different that they can do. So there's a real benefit in creating a team that creates a continuous improvement process, which is what we're trying to do. Having a format like this, as you can see, is much more interactive, you know, and that's the reason we like this format. And I have no problems with putting it on TV and things like that. But just the format really makes it an interactive process. And we all learn, we hear different ideas, we hear your thoughts. And so I think, you know, we have some refinement to do. We'll always have refinement to do. But I think the process works to help us be better as an organization. So, again, thanks for the time these last days. And, you know, we'll continue to take what we've heard from here and refine our budget process as we roll out and get to that July date when we make a budget recommendation.
Commissioner Justice.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And to that point, I was at a apologize.